शुरू तो ऐसे हुई कि आई वॉज इन सिक्स स्टैंडर्ड, दिस इज आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट 68, जस्ट बिफोर द दिवाली वेकेशन, वन ऑफ आर ड्राॅइंग टीचर्स ही हैड डन अ ड्राॅइंग ऑफ अ बॉय किकिंग अ फुटबॉल फ्रॉम साइड प्रोफाइल से. हमें सबको कहा कि यू नो ये आप कॉपी करो अपनी किताब में. आई डिड दैट ड्राॅइंग एंड आई फेल्ट दैट एज इफ यू नो आई हैव अचीव्ड द लाइकनेस, प्रपोर्शनेट था इमेज भी, वो था कि नहीं अब तो पता नहीं है, लेकिन तब ऐसे लगा. एंड उसके बाद पता नहीं क्या हुआ कि जैसे कोई भूत सवार होता है, आई वॉज कम्प्लीटली ऑब्सेस्ड विद ड्राॅइंग एंड पेंटिंग. ये पेंटिंग के लिए ऐसा एक घनिष्ठ लगाव जो पैदा हुआ, उसी दरमियान एक बड़ी अजीब घटना बनी मेरे साथ. उन दिनों दिवाली के गिफ्ट में मिठाइयाँ और स्वीट्स सब आते थे, तो मेरे मुंह में बिस्किट था. हम और दौड़े बाहर जाके खेल रहे थे, तो गिल्ली डंडा खेलते समय मेरे मामा भी थे साथ में, उन्होंने उनके हाथ में था डंडा और उन्होंने ज़ोर से गिल्ली मारी और मेरे ये राइट आई में लग गई. वो इतनी ज़ोरदार चोट थी कि यू नो आई फेल, माय आई वाज कम्प्लीटली फुल ऑफ ब्लड एंड इमीडिएटली आई वाज टेकन टू हॉस्पिटल एंड मलम पट्टी की, बट आई लॉस्ट द विजन. द डॉक्टर सेड वील वेट फॉर वन वीक एंड देन वील चेक अगेन. फिर लगा कि नहीं ये ऐसे नहीं चलेगा, ये कर लेना चाहिए ऑपरेशन. 1990 में ऑपरेशन करवाया, लेंस वॉज इम्प्लांटेड, विदेश से वो लेंस आया था, लेकिन मुझे कुछ विजन आया ही नहीं. तो फिर डॉक्टर ने कहा कि भाई तुम्हें यू नो सॉरी आपको तो रेटिनल डिटैचमेंट है, तो आप नहीं देख पाएंगे, तो आपको ऑपरेशन करवाना पड़ेगा. देन आई वाज सेंट टू अनदर डॉक्टर, ही चेक्ड, ही सेड कि भाई द आई विच इज़ फाइन, द लेफ्ट आई उसमें भी कुछ रेटिना में होल्स हैं, तो उसको हम क्रायो सर्जरी करेंगे. तो बर्फ की बहुत ठंडी सुई से हम उसको सील करेंगे, वो रेडियो में सोल्डरिंग करते हैं वैसे. तो ये ऑपरेशन हुआ, कुछ 6-7 दिन दोनों आँखें बंद थी. मुझे कहा कि आप घर पे रहिए, जून का महीना था, बरसात शुरू हो गई थी, बाहर का पानी आँख में जाने मत देना, लेकिन आप घर में बैठ के टीवी देख सकते हैं. और फिर तो आँख ठीक हो गई और तुरंत मुझे आमंत्रण आया, फ्रेंच गवर्नमेंट की स्कॉलरशिप मिली और मुझे पेरिस जाने का मौका मिला. So that was the first time at the age of 30-31 I went abroad. तारीख 2/9/92 ने शनिवार, चिरंजीव अतुल जोग पेरिस, लिखितं काकाना आशीष. बाद लखवानू के तारा तरफ थी नलिन पंड्या साथे मोकलेल चोपड़ियों तथा करमसी भाई नी चिट्ठी मळी गया छे. कागळ सीताबेने आंगळिया साथे मोकलेल चोपड़ियों विठ्ठल भाई ने घेर छे. मारी आगली बे टपाल मळी गई हशे, जेमा एक मां एक आर्टिस्ट नी आमंत्रण पत्रिका हती ने बीजीमां गीव पटेलनी कविता हती. आपणो श्री सदनो टेलिफोन आजे 8 दिवस थया केबल फॉल्टने हिसाबे बंद छे. तारीख 7/9/92 सुधी चालू थशे एम टेलिफोनवाळा कहे छे. तारी चिट्ठी तरत ज करमसी भाई ने आपी हती, एमणे तने फोन पर विगतवार जाण करी छे, छतां तेमणे मने लखेल चिट्ठी आ पत्र साथे मोकलू छूं. તેઓ આવતીકાલે બરોડા જાય છે, શા માટે જાય છે તે તેમની ચિઠ્ઠીમાં લખ્યું છે તે જાણશો. અહીં વરસાદ 10-12 દિવસ થયા પૂર બહારમાં ચાલુ છે, ઘણા ખરા બીમાર થઈ ગયા છે. આપણા ઘરમાં અજયને શરદી, સૌમિત્ર અમિતને તાવ અને પ્રીતિને મજા છે, તારી બા અને હું આનંદમાં છીએ. આ વખતે ચેમ્બુરના ગણપતિની ભવ્યતા ઘણી જ વધારી છે, રૂપિયા 1 કરોડનું ખર્ચ કર્યું છે એમ જોરદાર વાતો ચાલે છે. સુહાસને તારા આવવાના સમાચાર આપી દીધા છે. સૌમિત્ર મેં તો પિકાસો, મતીસ, એ સબ કોઈ લેકે દિમાગ મેં ઘૂમતા થા, તો જો શુરુ કી આર્ટ હુઈ તબ આને કે બાદ ઉસમેં વહી સબ થા કે મેરે પે જો ઇન્ફ્લુએન્સેસ હુએ, જો મેં જિનકો મેં હીરો માનતા હું ઉનકે બારે મેં કુછ કરું, ઉનકો મેરે કામ મેં કૈસે લે આઉં, અગર આ જાય તો ક્યા હોગા. તો એક બહોત બડા જર્મન આર્ટિસ્ટ હૈ, પેઇન્ટર હૈ, ગેરાર્ડ રિક્ટર. उन्होंने कुछ ऐसे भी पेंटिंग किए थे जो मैंने देखे थे पेरिस में, कि फ़ोटोग्राफ पे आधारित, लेकिन फ़ोटोग्राफ जो आउट ऑफ फोकस होते हैं, ब्लर फोटोग्राफ्स होते हैं, उसकी इमेजेस उसने बहुत सुंदर पेंट की थी, तो शायद उसका भी प्रभाव हो. लेकिन मैं एक सोच रहा था कि मेरे शहर और उसकी जो स्पेसिफिक एरियाज़ हैं उसको मैं पेंट करूँ. सो आई थॉट के क्यों ना हम ये जो ब्यूटिफुल मॉडर्न बिल्डिंग है चार्ल्स कोरिया ने बनाई हुई कांचनजंगा पेडर रोड पे, उसका मैं पेंटिंग करूँ तो कैसा रहेगा, ये सब्जेक्ट मैटर कुछ अलग रहेगा. तो आई वॉज एक्साइटेड, तो मैंने वीटी स्टेशन का वीटी से टैक्सी की एंड आई टोल्ड टैक्सी गाय कि थोड़ा धीरे आप चलना क्योंकि मैं कुछ फ़ोटो खींचना चाहता हूँ. तो उन्होंने कहा ठीक है. आई टुक सम पिक्चर्स ऑफ द बिल्डिंग एंड जब मैंने रोल डेवलप करने को दिया तो उन्होंने मुझे कुछ ही इमेजेस दी. तो मैंने कहा लेकिन मैंने तो टैक्सी में से भी कुछ खींचे थे. तो नहीं, ये तो आउट ऑफ फोकस है सब. तो मैंने कहा नहीं, तो ये आप प्रिंट कीजिए. तो पोस्ट कार्ड साइज़ में हमने वो प्रिंट की और फिर मैंने देखा तो मैंने क्यों ना मैं इसी को पेंट करूँ. तो इट रिमाइंडेड मी ऑफ रिक्टर्स वर्क. मतलब ये तो रिक्टर जैसा हो जाएगा, लेकिन मैंने उसको जुड़ा क्योंकि शहर थोड़ा जिंदा हो रहा था. ये सब घटना जो हुई वायलेंस और रायट्स और बम ब्लास्ट से, तो मैंने सोचा जैसे ये तो ऐसे लग रहा है कि जैसे मैं मेरी गिली आँखों से इस शहर को देख रहा हूँ. फिर मैंने कहा कि इसको मैं क्या शीर्षक दूँ. तो मुझे याद आया कि जब जब मैं ये मेरे पीरियोडिकल चेकअप के लिए जाता हूँ तो डॉक्टर फिर वो करते हैं, डायलेट करते हैं, उसको ध्यान से देखते हैं, फिर कहते हैं कि नहीं भाई और कोई नया घाव नहीं हुआ है आपकी आँख में, तो इट्स जस्ट नो फ्रेश लीजन्स, कोई नया घाव नहीं है. वो लिखते थे वो रिपोर्ट में. तो फिर मैंने सोचा कि मैं इसका भी शीर्षक वही दूँ कि कोई नया घाव नहीं है, लेकिन घाव तो कैसे पड़े शहर में लोगों के दिल पे, वो तो हम जानते ही हैं. This is one of the early painting when I returned from Paris. This work is called Night Studio. Myself painting in my old studio, which is in Wadi in Kamalin. My next door neighbors, Chakki, the handmill, which is there in a quiet solitude of night. But the whole thing as if it's painted on some sort of a old door. This was actually supposed to be, it used to be my home, with my family. We lived there for 30 years, and then when we moved to a new small apartment nearby, that old Wadi house became my studio. So earlier Anju and myself, we were sharing.
Chakki ma evi rite chhe, ame nana hata tyar thi, ame ahiya rahiye chhe, ahiya baju ma Harku ma rehta, ane oli side Jaya ben rehta. એ લોકો બે મંડળમાંથી મટીરિયલ લઈ આવે, એને દળવાનું કામ કરતા. સવારના 5 વાગે એ લોકો ઉઠી જતા અને ચક્કી દળવાનું ચાલુ કરે કે થેટ 10 વાગ્યા સુધી કરે એ લોકો સવારના, અને પછી પાછો બપોરના જમીને થોડો આરામ કરીને સાંજના. અને એ ચક્કીનો સાઉન્ડ એટલો સરસ લાગે ને કે આમ નશો ચડી જાય, ગુમ ગુમ ગુમ. એટલે એ એટલા માટે એ ટીયર એસ્કેપનું મારા ખ્યાલથી મને એમ લાગે છે એ સિરીઝ અતુલને એટલે સૂઈ જઈ છે એના ઉપરથી. કે આ બે લેડી એને અમે નાનપણથી જોતા આવ્યા છે એટલે
I often feel that you know, when you are working in your studio, you are not alone. You are surrounded, or kind of, you know, there are invisible ghosts, you know, hovering in the space. They are in the corners of your studio, and they are like, say, collectors, gallery people, curators, critics, then, you know, auction house, all these people, you know, they indirectly suggest that, you know, you do this and continue what is supposed to be successful, what is supposed to be fetching money. And artists also follow, but biggest enemy are not these people. Biggest enemy of an artist is his own past and his own, you know, oeuvre which he has done, because he also feels, well, when I did this, I was admired and I was successful and people loved it. So there is a inherent somewhere, you know, kind of a tendency that, you know, you keep on following the same stuff. अभी यहाँ पे एक दीवार आएगी. तो अमेरिकन आर्टिस्ट जो मेरा फेवरेट है, जैस्पर जॉन्स करके, उसने वो फ्लैगस्टोन पैटर्न कहते हैं, जो दीवार में पत्थर से बनी हुई दीवारों के जो जॉइंट्स को सीमेंट से करते हैं ना, तो ऐसे जो षष्ठकोण अष्टकोण जैसे वो आकार रहते हैं, तो वो हाँ तो वो जो है, दैट इज़ इंग्लिश में फ्लैगस्टोन पैटर्न कहते हैं उसको. तो वो दैट ही इज़ पेंटेड जस्ट वही. तो उसको पूछा कि भाई ये कैसे, तुमने ये कहाँ से आया? तो नहीं, एक बार हम लोग जा रहा था, मैं गाड़ी चला रहा था और एक तो सडनली डेड एंड आ गया, तो मुझे पीछे जाना पड़ा. तो पीछे जा रहा था ना, तो सामने वो दीवार पे वो पैटर्न थी, उन्होंने कहा ये तो बहुत खूबसूरत है. तो उसके बाद में उसका एक 10 साल का काम कुछ सिर्फ उसी के ऊपर है, दीवार के ऊपर की ये जो यहाँ पर आएगी एक दीवार. मैंने उसके हाँ अभी एक एनी मोमेंट इट शुड कम ऑन द लेफ्ट. ये देखो, ये है, देखा, ये देखो, लुक एट दिस बॉल, इट्स सो ब्यूटीफुल, लुक एट दिस, सी दिस. और अभी गीली हो गई है तो और भी बढ़िया लग रही है ये मौसम में. सी दिस, सो विराज, सी. तो मैं ये चुकता नहीं. हाँ, खास तो ये ऊंची है तो. हाँ, अब ये देखने से किसी को आनंद आए और गदगद हो जाए, खुश हो जाए, ये बड़ी है ना, ये भी एक कमाल की बात है ना, कि कोई आदमी ये देख के खुश होवे, इसमें क्या है? बस तो ये है, यू नो, यहाँ से शुरू हुआ, लुक एट दिस ग्रीन, हाँ, और यहाँ ये खत्म हुआ भाई. I was interested in this particular image for 2-3 reasons. One is that the film was made in 1959. I was born in 1959. Of course, father and son meeting, it's a moment of, joy, actually. At the same time, you know, there is some sort of a sadness. So there is a subtle smile on the actor's face, but still, there is some sort of, shadow. You do see a kind of a sailboat and a river, but suddenly in the background, there is a completely different kind of imagery. Now that is a work by, a major German artist who died in 86, Josef Beuys. He was a conceptual artist. And one of his works, the particular work which you see here in the center part, Josef Beuys called it Trans-Siberian Express. He was in the war and during the World War, and his plane was broken and he fell in Siberian region. But I thought that, essentially it's about journey. And also, if you remember the trilogy, Apu trilogy, where the motif of train has a very significant role to play. So I thought that it's interesting that how time has changed. What if I combine these two artists? Since I'm interested in both, I'm interested in Ray's lyricism, his humanism, as well as the kind of humanism and the poetics which generates Josef Beuys' work. तो मेरा जहाँ वाड़ी में मैं रहता हूँ वहाँ पे मेरा दोस्त था सुहास. तो सुहास ने कमर्शियल आर्ट किया था जीजी स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट से. तो वो मेरे से 4-5 साल बड़ा है. तो वो आता था. एक दूसरा दोस्त था रामू करके, वो तमिलियन था. तो और वो बड़ा होशियार था, इंटेलिजेंट था, इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज पे कमांड भी थी. तो हम रामू, सुहास, मैं, फिर मेरा दोस्त था एक नीरेन भट्ट, अब वो जापान में है, वो जेजे में साथ में था मेरे से थोड़ा बड़ा था. तो हम लोग चार दोस्त काफ़ी रामकृष्ण मिशन में जाते थे, वहाँ बैठते थे. उस पर रामकृष्ण मिशन, उनका जो दक्षिणेश्वर का जो घर है जहाँ पे उनका पलंग है और वहाँ पे अब तो उन्होंने फोटोग्राफ रखा है, तो उसका एक फ़ोटो, मैंने कहा ये मैं अगर पेंट करूँ तो कैसा रहे. और कभी मेरे दोस्त मुझे, क्योंकि मेरी सरनेम डोडिया है तो डोडो भी कहते थे, तो डोडो पक्षी तो अब इन ख़त्म हो गया, वो एक्सटिंक्ट हो गया है. और हम जो दोस्त थे हम भी अलग अलग हो गए, अलग अलग जगह पे रहने लगे, अलग अलग कारोबार में, फैमिली में मशरूफ़ हो गए. सो दक्षिणेश्वर का जो रामकृष्ण मिशन का जो बेड है उसको एज अ सेंट्रल मोटिफ रख के फिर हमारे शेडोज़ हैं पेंटिंग में. After Paris trip, when I returned and when I want, as I said, that I was moving away from certain naturalism, certain realism. So this is one of those early works during that period. And it's called O Naina. Naina is my sister, my elder sister. And she was suffering from a tumor on a pituitary gland, which is called pituitary adenoma. And so for many years she would be, either in hospital or, on sick bed, and then there were operations, So this is, it's a painting about a hospital bed. I imagine of a still life on that hospital bed. This still life is not of a surgeon's tools, used for the operation, but they are carpenter's tools, which is very loud and heavy and bold. So this, you know, to just to show her painful existence. Then of course there are two coconuts, and as if you know the rising sun from the two mountain peaks, it's rising his skull. So you know the death, fear of death was constantly hovering, and it was there. But and I could, what can I do? You know, I am not a doctor, and how to heal and how to give her a comfort. So I painted a sateen pillow, and then there is embroidery on it. And then there is, of course, you see also Rakhi. So it's just to kind of show that it's about sister and brother. This is a portrait of Jasper Johns. And my face is covered with a book, which is a goat and also bird, kind of a very puzzling, like kind of image. It's by Rabindranath Tagore. And I call this a scapegoat. Sometimes I feel that, you know, as if am I a sort of a parasite, that I need some support of some artist, whether it's a Tagore or Picasso or Johns or Guston, and use their, you know, ideas and their concept, and then sort of create my own stuff. Or is it a homage, or is it a kind of a, you know, sort of a, some sort of a imaginary dialogue to go close to him and try to understand, you know, how he thinks and how he works and how his you know, approach is. Basically, you know, my interest in the history of India's freedom movement and the history of modernity, modern art, which this both the histories were about, essentially about freedom. If you think of early 20th century paintings in France, particularly what Picasso and Matisse were doing. And now this specific one is, of course, in during the freedom movement struggle in Calcutta. When you think of Calcutta, you can't, you do think of Rabindranath Tagore. And so there is a Tagorean, actually Tagore image, you know, from Tagore's painting, which takes part of the painting. And since the whole thing is happening on the street of Calcutta, I got one image from early 20th century where they were selling auto rickshaws for 160, 170, 180 rupees. Japanese made rickshaws, hand pulling rickshaws, not auto rickshaws. But you know, I thought it would be interesting to kind of juxtapose a shutter, a closed shutter, and open painting, a street scene. And the idea of the abstraction, which came, of course, from by looking at Tagore's doodling over a poem, when he didn't like, or when he rejected few words in the poetry, he would cancel it with some form. Words have specific meaning. They say some specific things. So the specific and abstraction together in one small piece of paper, which is very fascinating, I thought. And of course, Tagore's painting emerged out of those doodlings, and he created some great works. So I thought, if I have a very concrete reality in the background, and combine it with some abstraction, what will happen? इमेजिन पीस, देयर इज अ पिन हियर इन द कैबिनेट विच इज एक्चुअली अ वर्क ऑफ आर्ट बाय योको ओनो. When things were getting juxtaposed, were getting selected, I realized that there is a poet, there is a saint, there is a mother, couple, lovers. The various phases of moon, a huge hammerhead shark. The approach is very different when I'm doing a flat painting and when I'm composing my objects, images into cabinets. You know, the distances between the object, the scale of an object, you know, the selection of the images in terms of photographs, it's because there is a vast amount of, you know, objects, photographs are available, but gradually I discard many and come to few, and there is a very fine inherent logic. Under that, they get connected. माथा उसकी भी एक कहानी है.
क्या कहानी?
वो कहानी ये है, इसी ड्यूरिंग दिवाली इन वाड़ी वी वुड ऑल यू नो प्ले विथ क्रैकर्स एंड ऑल. सो वो जो छोटे पटाखे आते थे, you know, for that we would kind of, you know, hit with a hammer. Around night, around 12 o'clock, my elder sister, just elder to me, her name is Kiran. She and I, we have 2 years difference between each other. We are playing and she was cracking with a hammer. And I said, no, you give it to me. She said, no, I won't. I want to play. So then I just, when she was not giving me the hammer, I just pulled the hammer from her hand and I hit on her head in the center. And it was, you know, full of blood and, you know, it was terrible sight. And everyone was shocked and everybody, you know, my parents came and they kind of, you know, we called the doctor and doctor came, doctor cut hair in the night from her top part of the head and put some bandage. So can you imagine that next day, you know, she was wearing a beautiful white kind of a silky frock, but this thing was there and I got a lot of bahut daat mili mujhe, but I just went and kind of, you know, in my rajai and went to sleep. So this incident, you know, I can't forget that hitting a hammer on the head. But hammerhead shark also has been coming in my work, because I noticed that hammerhead shark, I was reading about it, its head is like a hammer, and the eye, which is on the both the sides of the, you know, that head, so her vision is very wide, you know, it at a time, you know, she can encompass a huge amount of circular, you know, area. So I feel, you know, when I saw and when I think about my work, I feel that I am open to begin with. I'm open to vastness of the visual world, and that vast visual world is mine. If I say moon is mine, no one can snatch it from me. It's mine. Same way, you know, whether it's Picasso or Paul Klee Piero della Francesca or Giotto, whoever, you know, our own painters, Tagore, I think all they painted for me and it's mine. So very easily I kind of, you know, take and incorporate in my work these references, and you call it reference, you call it quotation, you call it kind of, you know, homage, whatever, that doesn't matter. But I think able to sort of, you know, grab or kind of hold much bigger area, which I like. So I would like to see myself as a hammerhead shark. Yeah, it is a large body of work in last 30 years I must have produced, and what I will be showing is something 10 to 15%. Three painters, Bhupen Khakkar, myself, looking at René Magritte painting. When we were looking at this painting in Rotterdam Museum, another friend was with us, and immediately I gave my camera. I said, "Okay, no, just take a picture," because I knew that Bhupen is white hair, I have a black hair, and you know, and two men in jacket looking at a man in jacket inside. So three painters, because Bhupen, myself, and Magritte is there. But you may wonder that, you know, why there is a pregnant woman, that's a sculpture by Picasso, on my back. And there is also another image from Picasso, female face on the top. So the reason is that, you know, my wife was pregnant, and you know, my daughter, she's here, she was supposed to come in this world. So I, you know, all the time I had this on my back of my mind, that, you know, I I said, you know, why not to add that? Because you see, revealing and concealing, these two aspects of work of art, enlarged belly and inside there is something. I thought this would be interesting to kind of, you know, put on very realistic painting, superimpose of, you know, another imagery. This is an important painting in many ways. You will see it in subsequent images which will come. It's called Lamentation. 1997, we were celebrating 50 years of independence, and we were invited for various shows. I did this large painting, half divided with Picasso painting and half with Gandhi, on an empty railway platform. We see his back of an old man, and Picasso painting where mother is holding hands of a young girl and she's learning to walk. And overall in the painting you see that there are, you know, lamenting angels. These are in Padua, in near Venice, in a fresco where the dead Christ's body is there, and this weeping angels, lamenting angels, are been painted by Giotto, great Italian early master. I thought Gandhi is no more. You see an old man and his back. Soon he will be gone, and he's already actually gone. And this young girl who is excited, little bit of, you know, fear on her face. And it's that painting Picasso did during the Spanish Civil War around 1937 and just before Second World War. And mother's face also has some anxiety.
her foot is lifted. And when I did this, I said, probably, you know, and my daughter was already 4 or 5. She was, of course, walking. And she, I said, what kind of a role she will have to play? She is coming towards us. Gandhi is going. And what kind of a role she will have to play? I said, she will have to play a role of Kali, probably. And when I said that, how to convey that? And I painted a Shiva image under her foot, which is from a Kali Ghat painting, Kali Ghat oleographs. So there is Shiva, there's a young girl who is learning to walk. This face, you know, beautiful face of a child, her name is Sharda. And there was a small news item in the tabloid in Bombay in midday, I still have it, that this 9 months young child in an orphanage in Hyderabad, her cornea was removed and sold for money. If she is alive today, probably must be 14 or 15 years young girl, but blind. Then around 2012, I was invited in Copenhagen for a museum show. I did some 8 shutters. And this one is called Highway Yogi. Sometimes the front image and inside image would correlate, has some relationship. Sometimes they don't at all, and that creates something else. So when it's half open, I'm fully aware that how it will look, you know. So the boy, you know, Mayurasana on the top, and the kind of Padmasana, but in a sleeping position in the bottom, and suddenly half tire falling, coming. So on various level, viewer can choose where he wants to stop and see the painting again. Mahalakshmi. There are some shutter paintings, but on canvas.
O toron mame kali mukhe kali antare toronai kali ma name kali mukhe kali antare toronai kali ma ebar tore.
मैं और अंजू हमेशा साथ में रहते थे, तो अंजू ने एक बार कहा कि तू ये जो फायूम पोर्ट्रेट्स हैं 2000 साल पहले इजिप्ट में हुए थे, कि जब ममी बनती थी तो उसके ऊपर वो जो आदमी गुजर गया है उसका पोर्ट्रेट उन लोग लगाते थे, वुडन पीस पे वो करते थे. तो अंजू सेड कि नो, सिंस यू वांट टू डू पोर्ट्रेट, यू डू पोर्ट्रेट, मेरा एक पोर्ट्रेट करो, लेकिन मेरे पोर्ट्रेट ऐसे करो जैसे वो फायूम की शैली में. तो मैंने कहा कि अरे, बिकॉज इट्स एक्चुअली जनरली डन फॉर अ डेड पीपल, यू नो, दोज़ हु आर डेड, उनके पोर्ट्रेट्स वहाँ पे लगते हैं. बट शी इंसिस्टेड कि नहीं, ऐसे कभी सोच ना करना.
ગાંધી બાપુએ કેરી ચૂસતા ચૂસતા કહ્યું, તારી ઊંઘમાં આંબાનું ઝાડ છે. હા, તમારી ઊંઘમાં હું કેરીઓ લઈને આવ્યો છું. હા, અને આપણે આમ ખાઈએ છીએ બકા, તારી ઊંઘના આંબાની કેરી મારી ઊંઘમાં. બાપુ, ક્લેરિટી નથી. શેની ક્લેરિટી બકા? ઊંઘની બાપુ, ગોટાળો થઈ જાય છે. લો ઉઠો. પછી મેં ને બાપુએ અમારી બે અલગ અલગ ઊંઘની વાડને રબરથી ભૂંસી નાખી. હવે ન મૂંઝવણ, ન ગોટાળો, એક જ ઊંઘ.
You know, while going through the Bako text, I also felt as if, you know, it's my story. Very imaginative boy and deep respect for Mahatma. First cabinet, and starts with a boy. From French film The 400 Blows by François Truffaut. Half of the film is shot in school. Next to the boy, the frame has Mohammed Rafi, well-known playback singer, with boxer Muhammad Ali. So Muhammad Rafi and Geeta Dutt, both are my favorite singers, most favorite. So there is a Geeta Dutt as well in this particular cabinet. There is a schoolboy sign which I took the picture in Shantiniketan, which is also there next to the Rafi and Muhammad Ali picture. Someone asked me that how I would like to remember as an artist, and I said that I would like to be remembered as Mohammad Rafi of Indian painting. There are also various sculptures of Dashavatar, Vishnu's 10 incarnation, and so universe and God and various incarnation of God. And in the midst of all this, there is a blind man. You know, not to be able to see, that could be the most traumatic experience in any human being's life. You also see myself above the black circle of Malevich, looking up as a young boy. Piles of books. I love books, and kind of a self-portrait with a flagstone pattern behind. And inside the brain, you see a handmill, chakki. Shardama is inside the cabinet with two
giant, I mean bigger, handmill stone, rendered with carpet and oil paint. Shardama is inside the cabinet with two giant, I mean bigger, handmill stone, rendered with carpet and oil paint. Philip Guston is someone who is extremely important to me, great inspiration, and I learned what is freedom of an artist from Philip Guston. There is a quotation by Philip Guston here in this particular cabinet, which says, "It's a long, long preparation for a few moments of innocence." This is one of the central cabinet. When I was 15 and 16, I read Lapshankar Thakur for the first time. And subsequently, when I saw the work by French filmmaker Jean-Luc Godard and paintings by Jasper Johns, I was stunned and amazed by the link which I could see between three totally different personalities, totally three different creative minds. Jasper Johns working in New York in 60s, Godard working in France, and Lapshankar Thakur writing poetry in Ahmedabad. When a language itself can become a subject matter for your creative work, what would happen? What kind of image or creative work will emerge when you make creativity the grammar of art, painting, or cinema, or language, your subject matter? I think all three, Jasper Johns, Jean-Luc Godard, and Lapshankar Thakur, were attempting the same thing in the same time, but in a different places. Robert Rauschenberg, I mentioned that earlier, quotation by him, when he was asked, "What is your greatest fear?" And he said that I might run out of world. I think this is how I sort of included the childhood and saluting my heroes in this cabinet installation called Meditation with Open Eyes.